First of all, I want to welcome project leader and architect Ulla Hahn from FutureBuilt. She will present a learning arena for sustainable materials. Welcome, Ulla.
As she said, I'm Ulla Hahn, an architect and project manager in the FutureBuilt program. And I will focus on how we have worked with materials in our program, learning with and from the pilot projects. FutureBuilt is a 10-year program from 2010 to 2020 to facilitate climate-friendly architecture and city areas. Working with pilot project is a possibility to show how to do it and to convince that it's possible. Possible to change the way we build our buildings. That was 50 projects, was a target in 2010, and today we have already more than 50 projects completed in construction or in planning, most of them in Oslo. There are 10 partners in the program, the four cities, Oslo, Drammen, Bærum, and Asker, and they are the main partners. And all the projects should have high architectural qualities, but also be innovative and show others how to build climate friendly. All the projects have to reduce carbon emissions by at least 50%. That's not easy. But we try, and it's from energy, transport, and materials. Today, I focus on the materials and only on the aspect of CO2 reduction. There are, of course, other important aspects. Then I should have more time, so it's mostly about CO2 reduction, and I'll show you some examples. That's the people we work with, the municipalities, architects, consultants, and contractors. And their enthusiasm is quite important to reach our goals, and it's about to have good dialogue. One of the first pilot projects was Talhall. It's a building with the cellar for the meteorological equipment. And to reduce emissions from the use of concrete we discussed at that time. I think the Talhall is the first building using low carbon concrete, a new prescription then. Now it's used in almost every new building. And it's also an example to reduce materials consumption when they used a perforated facade. We worked with that. And inside, of course, to use wood is a good choice. Another way to reduce emissions is the example from Papierbreden in Drammen. Also one of the first pilot projects we had. They did quite a lot to reduce steel and concrete by optimizing the construction. In the program, we have some school buildings, and Bjørnsletta School was the first passive house school in Oslo. And in this school, they used a lot of wood in the facade, but it's a construction, it's important, and they could not use low carbon concrete, but when they had these bubble decks, they could have it on site. So that was their way to reduce CO2 emissions by about 30%, I think. And all projects in the future program have to measure the reductions. Here from the Bjørnsletta School, you see the comparison of a reference building with the new school. The reference building is the blue one, and there you see the low carbon concrete. And for Bjørnsletta School, the black one, and also reused steel and other materials on the right side. All of the three new cultural buildings in Oslo are future built projects as well, and they have used low carbon concrete. It's not always possible to substitute concrete, so we are also working to inspire to work with new prescriptions for concrete, and we hope that in some of the new projects they will be in use, like the new building for the castle in Oslo and the new Klimahaus in the botanical garden just under construction or now. So you have to follow that. Then we have also one of the first projects in Fjell Kindergarten in Drammen. It was one of the first buildings built in massive wood construction in the Oslo region. And to reduce CO2 emissions in the main construction is important, and it's obvious that wood matters. We have heard that before today. Fjell Kindergarten could reduce CO2 emissions from materials by 50%. That's from the carbon emission measuring tool we have used until now. Now it's one-click LCR, but it was klimagassregnskap.no that time. Now massive wood buildings are in line. Here a housing project in Oslo with awards for excellent architecture, and they got also the Trepristen, the wood award. And last year we got also the first high-rise project in Oslo, student housing, 11 stories in cross-laminated timber. Here's the facade when it was finished last year. But it's not only about the materials inside. We have another example, not a wooden building, but an interesting energy approach. When using solar energy, there is also a possibility to integrate the panels in the facade or roof in that way to substitute facade materials. Here the plaque facade is all PV panels. That's Brunseng School in Oslo. So you can't almost not see that's the PV panels. It's integrated in the facade. Powerhouse Cherbo in Bærum is a rehabilitated office building that produces more energy than it uses. And of course, rehabilitation is perhaps the best way to reduce carbon emissions. But this building is also an example how to reuse materials. Old windows are used as walls inside. And that is something we have started to work with more and more. Circular buildings. We had a study tour to the Netherlands last year with the municipalities, developers, architects and consultants to visit exciting new projects. Netherlands, a country with lack of resources, has been working for a long time with new methods to reduce the consumption of materials and new methods to reuse them. And we just worked out criteria for circular buildings in the Future Built program. On the left side, you see the criteria, the first page, and it's on our website, so you can have a look afterwards. And there are three pilot projects testing this criteria now, two in Oslo and one in Asker. More about that coming soon, I hope. On our website, we try to give more information about the project and collect experiences. So you can read more about every project and also about the materials used. I want to just summarize a little bit. I think there is a big difference from 2010 when we started FutureBuilt. By then, to think about carbon emissions from materials was not a topic. Today, there's a bigger awareness to discuss the choice of materials, not only carbon emissions, but also other aspects. We want, of course, to share, and therefore we organize different workshops, seminars, and site visits to all projects, and have our conference every year. This year is special. As part of Oslo being the green capital, we arranged an international conference in May. I hope you join our conference future. We expect 3,000 participants from all over the world, 200 speakers. There will be a lot of seminars, workshops, exhibitions, 40 field trips, side events, and parties. Have a look at the program so far. Thanks.